Hey guys, Gwynedd here, bringing me the finals from MPDC 15-7. This is game two of the final match. Fabio S is playing a Kaldotha Burn deck, and Magic Point is playing Mono Black. And like I mentioned, a Magic Point won the first one, and so here we go on the second one. Let's get into it. Presumably Fabio is going to choose to play first. He does. Let's see how he opens. Mountain go, and looks like swamp go. All right, pretty. Neither of them has a one drop. Presumably Fabio will have a two drop though. Does have a mirror sire, and then back on his turn, Magic Point responds with a perilous mirror. Good defensive position to survive the long game. And naturally, Fabio's going to go ahead and attack in here because the Perilous Mirror won't get the 2-for-1 if he blocks, but Magic Point chooses not to block, which is the right thing to do. And then Fabio's just going to go ahead and use Geist Swim here, get it off the board since he didn't take the trade. And then Magic Point presumably will kill the first half of the Mirror Sire. It gets replaced, and we go from there. And then Fabio follows that up with a Perilous Mirror of his own. Magic Point goes ahead and uses Deadweight on the Perilous Mirror, and then takes two from the trigger, and then goes ahead and uses Soaring Thirst on the mirror. This is a great card for Mono Black to bring in this particular matchup, since not only is the two damage relevant, but the life gain is very, very relevant, helps you stay alive against the burn. So even though he takes two, he goes ahead and gains two and breaks even on the deal, so pretty good for him. So back on Fabio's turn. Plays a fourth land. It's, again, quite a few lands. Has a second Perilous Mirror as well as a Flare Husk. And we'll pass it back to Magic Point. Magic Point has a second Perilous Mirror of his own. Go ahead and hold the troops back there. And then, okay, so Fabio's going to go ahead and sacrifice his Perilous Mirror to get the Kaldotha Rebirth going. And then we'll target the Perilous Mirror, which goes ahead and has to deal the two damage before the Goblin tokens come down, so that's pretty good. Goes ahead and just ends up killing the Germ. And so Fabio is left with a Flare Husk and three 1/1 tokens. He will go ahead and equip one of them and pass the turn back. Magic Point goes ahead and pays the life and then gets the Vault Scourge out for a single mana. Help him trade with some of the Goblin tokens, and then is able to find a life staff as well, which he will equip up. Looks like Fabio does not have anything he can do about that, which will help him stay alive a little longer. So here, he goes ahead and recurs the Geist Flame. Makes sense. Just go ahead and get it off the board. Now he does get three life out of the deal, but then Fabio can swing in for four here. All right. And then back on Magic Point's turn, plays his fourth land of his own, and then has a Gravedigger. Presumably will go, yeah, he goes ahead and gets the Perilous Mirror here, puts that back in his hand, and passes the turn back. Back on his turn, Fabio goes ahead and Galvanic Blasts the Gravedigger, and will once again hit for four, dropping Magic Point to 12. Magic Point plays a fifth land, and goes ahead and finds, of course, the Perilous Mirror he recurred. Uses the life staff on it, and Fabios can retaliate with a Brimstone Volley to take it back off the board. Obviously, he will go ahead and use the ability from the Perilous Mirror to take out that Goblin, but it makes sense to go ahead and use the Brimstone there to prevent the Sylvic life staff from being equipped and gaining more life, since Fabio has a clear board advantage here. So, from this point, let's see what goes on next. Fabio finds Ichor Wellspring and draws another card off of that, and then finds a curse as well. Tell you what, in this particular tournament, every game I lost, I actually lost to this card right here, Curse of the Pierced Heart. I don't think it's very good by itself, but you get them in multiples, especially early on, and they just do a ton of damage, and they're very difficult for your opponent to interact with because there are not that many enchantment removal spells that are in the metagame, although now that Hexproof has become a thing, there's certainly a lot more than there used to be. My problem was I just couldn't draw enough of them to keep all those curses off the board. I think in most games my opponent found at least two, and three was not uncommon, so it was very sad for me. So just swings in for two, And then Magic Plane will start taking damage from the curse. And he's going to need something pretty good here. Just plays the Dusk Hunter without the Bloodthirst, but does go ahead and get it equipped up. And see if that slows Fabio down at all. Plays a Mirror Sire. Presumably we'll just keep swinging in here, which he does. So Magic Point goes ahead and kills off one of the Goblin tokens, and surprisingly doesn't. I probably would have traded with the other one and gained the life, but so Fabio follows that up with second Mirror Sire. Magic Point loses a point of damage and is going to attack here with the Dusk Hunter Bat. That's a really, really aggressive move considering he's at 7 life and is getting hurt by that curse every turn. Presumably as a follow-up play. Second Dusk Hunter Bat. Okay, so he wanted to activate Bloodthirst, not terrible. Has a Flare Husk as well, which he can then go ahead and equip. Oh, I see he's gonna put the Life Staff on the Germ token. Interesting. Okay. So let's see what happens next. Fabio goes ahead and equips the Goblin. And actually, it's just going to take a defensive stance. Makes sense because Magic Point is actually dead in 6 turns unless he's able to do something. See how he chooses to play this. Presumably, yeah, he'll go ahead and suit up his two bats to go ahead and swing in for as much damage as possible. But I still don't think he's going to be able to race. Let's see. Excuse me. Yeah, I mean 16-4. I mean technically, if the board didn't change, I think Fabio could still probably kill him before those bats could take him out. But you know, I guess that's his only choice at this point. That's the other thing about this card is that it forces even when you're not the beatdown, you basically have to race it. I mean that's your best option against it. If you can't remove it, and Black has absolutely no way of removing it, you have to race it, which means however much life you have no more than that many turns to go ahead and win the game, which forces you to be very aggressive, which against an aggressive deck is usually bad news. Goes ahead and does have the Fume Spitter here, which is good. Can use the Life Staff on it and gain some extra life. Keep him alive a little longer. So now Fabio goes ahead and just swings in with everything. He's going to block with the Fume Spitter and then kill off something else and trade the Germ Token to prevent the damage from the Mirror Sire. So he gains life, takes a couple points of damage, Mirror Sire returns. And then Fabio is just going to go ahead and equip the Flare Husk and pass the turn back. Magic Point loses another point from the curse. Suits up the Dust Cutter Bats. No, he's going to put them all on one. Okay, guess that's fine. So he can swing in with one, drop Fabio down to 10, and then presumably move the equipment back over. Yeah. And plays out his last card, goes ahead and suits up the Dusk Hunter Bat. Not really sure that makes a big difference there since a 2-1. I mean, I guess it allows him to block the Mirror Sire, so that's probably a good move. But see, now it doesn't. Oh, well, he's got to put it on one or the other. Okay, interesting. So he'll just swing in with the Mirror Sire. Force the trade. Magic Point gets a bunch more life, or even on life. But Fabio definitely has a slightly, I don't know, they're pretty even, I suppose. See if he's got a follow-up play. He's just going to equip the Mirror Token and pass it back. All right, Magic Point drops to 9. And here he's got the burn spell to take out the Dusk Hunter Bats, so that's bad news. So unless Magic Point has a play here, which he does not, all right, that's probably game. He will do 3 plus 4 from the curse. And if he's got anything else, okay, yeah, and he's got a Mirror Sire, that's probably how it's going to end. See if he Magic Point finds a dead weight to get rid of the Mirror Token, but probably not going to be enough. He'll take 3 here, and if Fabio has a burn spell at all, that's game. Sorry, he'll take 4 here. Doesn't really make a difference. 5, 3, or 4, dropping him to 2, drops to 1 from the curse. And unfortunately, all Magic Point is able to do is draw a life staff. So, and that's how it ends. Fabio actually doesn't have to do anything, but goes ahead and swings in anyway for the win. Oh, let's see. And Magic Point has a Soren's Thirst, so he will gain 2 life. So I guess it buys him a turn. And Fabio re-equips the mirror. Magic Point loses the point of damage, doesn't like what he draws, and goes ahead and concedes. So that was game 2. I'll be back in a minute for game 3.